My name is Joyce Moy, and I'm the Executive Director of the Asian American Asian Research Institute here at the City University of New York. I want to welcome all of you and thank you for joining us in this Spring Festival celebration. AAARI just celebrated its 10th anniversary. We had a wonderful dinner in November of last year at which there were nearly 500 people in attendance. And as always, we had a great time. We were able to celebrate our alumni, all of the prior recipients of the Distinguished Asian American Alumni Award came back. They brought friends, they brought tables, and it was just a great event at which students, faculty, staff, and community leaders from the business community, from the various diverse Asian American communities came together and had a great time. As many of you have seen, we have put together this booklet called Global Thinking, Local Voices, which documents a lot of the work that we've done over the past 10 years, talks a little bit about our mission going forward, and we're hoping that all of you will join us as we work towards this mission of educating people about the Asian American communities here in the United States and about the Asian communities throughout the world. And we see that it is more and more important that people begin to understand the role that Asians have played in the history of the United States, for example. And it's really up to us to make sure that our students and the communities in general know something about us. And we hope that you'll join us in this endeavor. We have a conference coming up on April 27th, which will be an East and West Coast comparative. So we're talking about the differences in the development of our communities on the East Coast and West Coast. I happen to be a fourth generation of my family in the United States. My children, who are in their mid-20s and up, are now the fifth generation. So we have a very long history in this country, and there are lots of people that don't know that. There is a timeline in this booklet that was developed that we hope all of you will look at and also can use in your instructions to let people understand a little bit about the role that Asians have played in the history of this country. I think I want to introduce a distinguished guest this evening, Richard Savior, who is the Assistant Dean of the Division of Academic Affairs at Hostos. Dean Savior, would you stand up and say hello? I might put you on the spot and turn over the mic to you, or ask you to come up and just say a few words. We do this to new deans and members of the administration that join us.
And do any of those deans ever come back?
They do, in fact.
Well, I'm very honored to be here, and thank you so much for that gracious invitation. I'm relatively new to CUNY. I spent my last 8 years in higher education working for a private university with a very global focus. I was responsible for overseeing campuses throughout Asia, North America, and the Middle East. And one of the things that I was discussing with Joyce is hopefully making a contribution to broadening the scope and scale of international education, not just at my institution, Hostos Community College, but perhaps more broadly within CUNY. There are just so many wonderful opportunities for both academic and experiential education that we can expose our students to. That don't necessarily mean getting on a plane, but there are ways that we can collaborate internally. We're in a city that is about as multicultural as they come, and thus there are many opportunities from abroad that we can expose our students to. So I'm looking forward to spending time here and making a contribution to this organization as well. So thank you.
Thank you very much, number one, for being a good sport and for coming back next year. We'll be looking for you. I think at this time, I'd like to introduce a couple of our board members. There's Loretta Chin from Brooklyn College. Loretta, would you stand up and say hello? Don't worry, I'm not going to make you speak.
Hello.
Nehru Cherrapalli. Oh, would you stand up and say hello? Also from Brooklyn College. And we have Jennifer Hayashida from Hunter. Jennifer is the director of the Asian American Studies program at Hunter, and I'm going to ask her to come up and just say a couple of words about the program, because some of you may not be aware of this particular program.
Thank you, Joyce. So I'm Jennifer Hayashida. I'm the director of the Asian American Studies program at Hunter College. We are an academic program. We offer courses in Asian American Studies that focus to a certain degree on Asian American communities in New York City. We also offer co-curricular programs on Asian American history and experience, and we offer a minor, a 12-credit minor, for our students looking to enhance their major fields of study with scholarship on Asian American history and contemporary issues. I guess the one thing I would like to say just in this context is that one of the key ways in which Asian Americans and Asian American studies can grow stronger within CUNY is that we organize along our interests as scholars, as researchers, as students, as administrators, and that we see, that we will hopefully see some progress being made in terms of advancing Asian American studies as a priority within CUNY. Because since the Asian American community or population of New York City has grown and is now well past the 1 million mark, we're also seeing consequent increases in the Asian American student population within CUNY. And not only do our courses and do our respective interests as administrators and scholars and teachers serve those students, but we're also training all students to work in the city, because they will, at one point or another, be interfacing with an immigrant community. And to that mission, Asian American Studies provides a wonderful, wonderful blueprint for understanding immigrant experience in the 21st century. So I would encourage all of you to get involved with AAARI and to get involved with whatever efforts there are on your respective campuses to expand Asian American Studies curricula. So thank you very much, and have a great night.
Thank you, Jennifer. You know, just so that you're aware, we have 47,000 Asian American students, faculty, and staff within CUNY. Some campuses have very large Asian populations. For example, Baruch's current population is over 37%. Susan Wong, who is a counselor in the Sikh program at Baruch, is here and a member of our board. Susan, do you want to say anything about the students at the Baruch? Okay. Also, we have Nazru Khandakar from York College, another member of our board. We have James Lapp, who's a member of our board from New York City Tech. And we have Kyoko Toyama from LaGuardia Community College. We have Carol Huang from City College. She's also been our research coordinator and a tremendous help in getting our research agenda together. I also want to invite all of you to fill out the form that we have at the registration table. We are putting together a speakers bureau and a list of subject matter experts to give out to media when they call us looking for experts on particular subjects. Now, these may be experts about particular Asian American communities or particular aspects of those communities, such as children or women and so forth, or English language, second language speakers, or they're looking for an Asian perspective on an issue around biology or a technology issue. So if you're interested in being part of the group that, or the lists that we provide to these, for these inquiries, please make sure you fill out that form. Now, I'm trying to decide whether I should have each of you get up and introduce yourselves. If you haven't already been introduced, I get somebody here who's shaking his head, but I think I'm going to ignore him because he does that every year. I think I'm going to start over here and just ask you to introduce yourself, your name, your department, and perhaps one or two words about yourself.
Hi. My name... Oh, sure. My name is Jennifer Tang. I'm from HOSTOS. community college. I am a faculty member in the library, I want to just say hello.
Thank you. Kishore Marathe, Brooklyn College and Graduate Center, Mathematics and Physics.
Nehru, why don't you, your area of expertise, people should know.
Yeah, my name is Nehru, and I recently retired from Brooklyn College, but I'm still quite active. I'm a geologist by profession, and I also have knowledge of several different Indian languages, and I used to be giving lectures here in the past, but I'm still willing to. But I wear a lot of hats, whatever it demands. Thank you.
Thank you, Joyce. I'm Dara Sukdev. I was here from the very beginning when Dr. Thomas Tam started AAARI. I was one of the fortunate people that he called upon to help him. I'm not faculty at CUNY. I am an Indo-Caribbean expert. There are a lot of Asians in the Caribbean, as many of you may very well know. And as an expert from the community, he asked me to come in and help them with the Asian conferences and the South Asian conferences, and I was able to do that. I'm still here. I still believe in what AAARI is doing, and I encourage you to tell all your Asian students to be part of AAARI. Thank you.
I'm Emil Chi. I am at the College of Staten Island in the Department of Computer Science, along with my colleague Sean here. Many, many years ago, a long time ago, I also participated in a college trip to China that was undertaken by the predecessor of the College of Staten Island, then Staten Island Community College. That's ancient history, though.
Hi, my name is Xiaowen Sam, also from the College of Staten Island, from the Computer Science Department.
Hi, my name is Lin Liang. I'm from BMCC CUNY. I'm also from Computer Information System Department.
Hi, Happy New Year to everybody. My name is Chigrupat Rani. I'm also from BMCC, Computer Information Systems. I think we missed you here.
No.
Thank you. I'm Cui Xiangyi from Queen's College. My research field is macrometeorology. This is my wife.
Hi, my name is Li Guan. I'm a PeopleSoft programmer, work for the Central Office CIS Department. If you have PeopleSoft problem, I can help.
My name is Masa Nakamura from City Tech, Mechanical Engineering. This is my first year to join in CUNY, so I'm happy to be here.
Hi, I'm Kyoko Toyama. I'm a counseling faculty in a college discovery program at LaGuardia Community College. I've been in CUNY for over 20 years, more than 20 years.
I'm James Lapa, director of the evening and summer sessions at the New York City Tech and the treasurer of AAARI. If you want to contribute anything, please contact me.
He does turn it over to us.
Hello, my name is Lili Shi. I'm a new assistant professor from Kingsborough Community College. My research focus is intercultural communication, particularly feminist thoughts and immigrant women, first generation immigrant women, some identity negotiation. I actually just got a CUNY grant for this, so I'm actually here for our research collaborations, and also I'm new to New York. I need to get to know more friends. So,
here they are. My name is Hong Mian Gong. My research area includes urban geography, GIS, GPS, China, urban transportation. Thank you.
I guess too many geologists here, right?
Okay, my name is Nazrul Khandukar. I'm one of the CUNY, AAARI board members. I teach at your college, also geology. But unlike Dr. Nehru, you know, he said he retired, I'm a new kid on the block.
Thank you. Hi, my name is Gisela Jia. I'm from Lehman College Psychology Department. I've been working there for 14 years. I'm a child psychologist, so I teach courses related to child development. My research area is, I study immigrant children, particularly from Asian, those who speak Asian home languages, how they learn English, how they maintain their home language. And I do go to the communities a lot, speaking to parents about their children's development. Yeah.
Good evening. My name is Holger Henke. I'm the assistant provost at York College. I'm here to support Naz, who is representing York College. I'm here because I'm in the provost office. So this is my third or fourth time, I believe, here. Thank you for having me again. In my former life, I was a Caribbean studies scholar. So I share my colleagues' interest in the Asian communities in the Caribbean. Maybe it's because of that that I met my wife, whose grandfather was from India.
thanks, our director gave us opportunity to introduce each other. I was an instructor of the Asian America Asian Research Institute. I was also a professor of Suzhou University in China and Zhengpo National University in Korea. I have class to teach you Chinese literature and movie. My master program major is Chinese movie. Right now, I try my best to translate my book into English. I published 5 books into Chinese about introduce Chinese movie. One of the book I hope can translate into English. So I talk with our director. I have no idea how to translate my book into English. She will help me. So thank you. Okay, thank you, all of you. Yeah.
Good evening. My name is Cam Wong, and I have a very long title. It's Associate Director for Workforce Diversity and Compliance Program. I have to take a big breath, which basically means that I'm the Diversity and Compliance Officer for all 1,200-plus central office employees. I work out of CUNY Central Office at 80th Street. In terms of what I could possibly help colleagues across the university, I manage 2 university-wide diversity programs. They are the Diversity Projects Development Fund and the Faculty Fellowship Publication Program. So if you have questions with regard to those 2 programs, feel free to contact me.
Carol Huang, my home base is in City College in the School of Education. And I was at AAARI for 1 year, have a tremendous experience, enjoy really much, very much here as a research coordinator. And I hope that if you have research projects and you want to work with us, please contact me, Carol Huang, Huang.
My name is Xiaoyue Jenny Chow, abbreviated Jenny Chow. I've been with Baruch College for 22 years. My only job in the United States, and I've been holding for that long. My research interest, well, I'm a faculty librarian. My research interest is in the family history and Chinese genealogy. I've been writing several books in the subject and getting several CUNY grants. I think this is the 4th one which I'm working on about the third generation of the first president in China, Yuan Shikai. And I've been collaborated with my collaborator. She is She's actually from Lehman, Professor Lehman, also a faculty librarian, and she is the third generation of President Yuan Shikai. And anyhow, we're still working on the book, and the book's supposed to be off press soon, but we're still working on it, especially this second part of the grant, which we traveled together 2 years ago, and to China in many places of those big cities, like Beijing, Tianjin, Shanghai, Henan, almost a whole month, and close to a whole month under the CUNY grant support. And now our upcoming trip will be in this coming April, which is the updating of the data, which is, you know, there are new people coming, there are some other unfinished things in our oral history that we wanted to update. So that's what I'm working on. But besides that, I have other interests. My undergraduate is in Spanish, so I'm pretty good at speaking the language, as well as the Asian diaspora of the Chinese in those countries, in Hispanic countries, and I'm also I'm a consultant at the Instituto Estudio for the Dominicano at the City College. So because I'm a cataloger, and I'm pretty much in charge of all the collection, doing cataloging and processing. So I'm also interested in the diaspora. I'm trying to write a paper researching the Chinese, actually they call it the Badrio Gino, Chinese that immigrated in Dominican Republic. So that's the, and thank you very much.
Hi, good evening. My name is Alan Lee. I assist Professor Mitch Wu at Hunter, but I'm not officially faculty there. I'm my interest is in metaphysics from a Cantonese perspective, like thanks for the photograph. Like before, like the Cantonese joined China. I'm also a blogger at WBAI Radio, and nice to meet you, folks.
Hi, my name is Paul Ewan. I'm the fencing coach at the City College of New York. There's a diversity workshop tonight for which I got up off because I had to work. No, I just wanted to crash the party. Anyhow, it's my first time here. The last 2 or 3 years I wasn't able to come because I had competition, but today I wanted to meet Joyce and for the first time, and it's a good party. I like it.
Thank you. I took fencing for
1 semester.
I did.
No. Hi, my name is Jack Poe. I'm an adjunct faculty in math education at City College. I'm actually also an MD-PhD student in Columbia, and I do a lot of education reform and healthcare policy at the White House. And I actually haven't had as much interactions with Asian American focused efforts in the last decade. So I'm really interested in both getting re-engaged with those type of efforts and the efforts at City College.
Hi, Happy New Year. I'm Xiang Dongli from Computer Information System at City Tech. This is my 10th year in the department.
Yes, my name is Q Lee from the Philosophy Department of John Jay College of Criminal Justice, and I have been having a great privilege and pleasure to be able to run a faculty seminar at AAARI, and so hopefully we'll be able to resume that fairly soon. Thank you, and if you have any question, my job is to question back, so feel free to come and talk to me as a philosopher.
Hi, my name is Angie Reyes. I'm a faculty in English at Hunter College and in anthropology at the Grad Center. And my research is on issues of language and race among Asian American communities, particularly Southeast Asian American youth and Korean American youth. I'm doing a study now on a Hagwon, an Asian American cram school in Queens. So.
Hi, I'm Juna Shadoya, and I'm an adjunct at LaGuardia Community College in the counseling department, and I'm also a career counselor at Baruch College. And at Baruch, I really enjoy helping the students, but especially I'm a liaison to student athletes, the international students, and I'm also the campus coordinator for federal jobs. I also do career-related programming and leadership, so that's what I do. Nice to meet you.
Okay. Hi, my name is Roberto Benediro, and I'll make this short and sweet, but I'm the coordinator of the Cultural Diversity Program at York, and
just got the position.
I teach with the Department of History and Philosophy. I have a PhD in anthropology, and how I got to the department is a long story. So ask me, just ask me. Thank you.
Hello, thank you for allowing me to come today. And this is a wonderful opportunity. This is my first time here, so I'm really having fun. My name is Mei Ng. I work at LaGuardia in the math department. I'm the adjunct in the evening, and during the day, I'm a math teacher in the public schools. So, okay.
Hello, everyone. My name is Frank Wang. My research interest includes mathematics, economics, finance, and investment and strategies. My current research was China's real estate markets. And my current job focused on consultants, includes especially in financial service and clean technology, energy technology. So I can. That's my current job's focus. Okay, thank you very much. Okay.
Happy New Year, everybody. My name is Zhou Tianxi, and I was into Xing Nengyuan. My name is Tony Chow, and then my major is research the clean technology and the clean coal technology. So research purpose, present time now. I have no job right now, just just retire, you know, I'm honest with you. That's it.
Hi, my name is Alice Wong. I currently work with the Invest in CUNY campaign, and I'm a past graduate of Baruch College, majored in business journalism.
Hi, my name is Ina Malone. I'm also with the Invest in CUNY campaign office. Anybody want to donate to the various colleges that have campaigns and are raising money? I'd like to thank you very much for the invitation. This is my second year attending your function, and I enjoy it very much. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Mary Ting. I'm an artist and an adjunct at John Jay College. I also am part of the graduate faculty at Trans Art Institute, which is a new graduate program college that meets out of New York and Berlin. I also just recently got a grant from the Lower Manhattan Cultural Council, and it's for a community project that deals with grief and mourning. So you can come and talk to me about that.
Well, we need to connect you to this grant the Asian American Arts Alliance is doing.
Oh, sacred, yeah. Okay, thank you, we'll talk.
I am Korean. I am private practitioner, Chinese medicine, acupuncture, herbal medicine. So about 40 years, we are interested more in the propagation. What is Oriental medicine?
Um,
My name is Moon Kim. I'm an independent consultant on process engineering and natural resource development. Thank you.
Hello, everybody. My name is Yi Lu. I'm assistant associate professor from John Jay College of Criminal Justice, and my field of study is in public management and budgeting, in particular government accountability and performance, those catchy fancy words that I'm doing study on. And one of my recent grants is from IBM Center for the Business of Government, and because my prior focus is on US state government, recently I branched out to China, Singapore as well, so that's my interest in attending this activity, try to know more about how I'm going to do more research on Asian society. That's what I'm doing.
Thank you. My name is William Sitt. I'm of the City College Mathematics Department. I have taught there for 34 years, and I have since retired for about 6 years. I'm still rather active. I continue to run a seminar at the Graduate Center. My research area is, technically called differential algebra. And what it means is that it's studying the algebraic properties of differential equations. For example, you want to compute an integral, then you will have to have some theory to back up how to do that. And so the field has applications to symbolic computation, where engineers use them to solve differential equations as well as to perform integration, so that your students, if you have a package of Maple or Mathematica, then they will do an integral much better than any one of us. I think that's... Oh, okay. Since I retired, I support a group, mostly Asian, but not all Asian, called Ensemble 212. It is a small group of musicians, about 30 or so, and they perform regularly at a church near Lincoln Center. And I would like to see if there is some grant that such an ensemble could get, so that I can help them. Right. Thank you.
To talk with us. Okay. We're looking for folks who may have projects that they may need a small grant and financial support for. Possible collaborators across CUNY. There's great opportunities to get grants when there's cross-collaboration across the campuses, and we would try to help matchmake. That's one of the reasons we want you to know one another. So to the extent that you're looking for a place out of which to originate research, perhaps AAARI can be helpful. If we can facilitate that research or those grants or those projects or opportunities that you have, let us try to help you connect
to
other resources.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Claire Sitt. I used to teach at La Guardia Community College, where Coco and May and our faculty before. And I retired maybe 8 years ago. I forgot exactly. But since then, I've been working very hard and have written 2 books, which are about philosophy or religion between the West and the East. One is I use the Eastern perspective to examine the Lord's Prayer, and that is this one. And then I use the Western philosophy to examine the Tao Te Ching by Lao Tzu. You can look at these 2 books from Amazon.com. There are many, you can sample them, or if you like, after we introduce ourselves, you want to come and take a look, you can examine them. And thank you very much for letting me to introduce myself and also my work.
Thank you. You know, it's important that we promote ourselves and each other. And we're here to support you. If you have recently published a book and you would like to do a book talk and to make those books available during that talk, let us know. Let's see what we can do about supporting you and your publications. We video all of these talks, these lectures, these panel discussions, and so forth, and they're posted on our website. We get tremendous numbers of hits.
Hi, my name's Philip Lee, and 5 years ago, I was an AAARI staff member, and then this was 5 years ago. Now I'm residing in New York City College of Technology as a media service technician. My friend James over there could tell you that, because that sees me running around all the time. But like, that's basically it. I'm glad to see everything is evolving for the last 5 years, and I'm interested to see new faces as well.
Hi, my name is Eric Moy. I'm a senior college lab technician from LaGuardia Community College. I work in the library overseeing all the computer operations.
Hi, my name is Sam Heng. I'm from New York City College of Technology. I'm in the Department of Computer Engineering Technology. And my research interest is in software development, embedding system, and gaming theory. And I guess that's all I have to say.
Hi, my name is Andy John, also from City Tech. We are together. Actually, we hand out earlier a flyer, which is a robotic tournament of champions. We are hosting this event in April 28th. In case you have students want to participate, yeah, we are welcome to submit your applications through the website we listed here. All right, thank you.
That's great. If you send it to us, we'll circulate it electronically as well, post it on our website.
Okay, good evening, everyone. My name is Lin Song. In fact, I am a visiting faculty in Baruch College. My major is management, and more specific is it's about Chinese entrepreneurship. Okay.
Yeah, my name is Nathan Chow. My dad's colleague was Betty Liu Song's husband, and my wife did research for Betty Liu Song when she was writing her books in the early 70s. I myself am a teacher at Queensborough Community College. I've been there for 43 years. And I installed the only solar panels there. So if any campus is interested in solar panels, I've been doing a lot of work on solar panels. And with respect to some of the previous people that spoke, my grandson was just ranked nationally, 14 years of age, at Epe Fencing. You see a Chinese face there. And my wife ran the Asian American Women's Association back in the 70s with Esther Key, Norman Lockheed's wife. And she went to Washington representing Asian American women during the Carter administration. So I'm an old timer here.
Thank you. Very impressive.
Hi, you met me. My name's Loretta Chen. I'm a research coordinator at Brooklyn College. I've been there for over 20 years. I've been here working with Joyce and members of AAARI since it started. And I'm very, very happy to see all of you here tonight. It's just wonderful to have this come out of everything that we've put together and worked with Joyce over the years with. I'm very happy also to see Philip Lee. Philip was a student of mine when I was in student affairs. And he was actually the president of Asian Infinity, was it? The club?
That was the other club.
Okay, but you were active. Okay, active in Asian Student Union. And with that club, we had over 400 people one night for Asian Night, right, that event?
Yeah.
So I would love to see more of our students return. That's really gratifying to see you here tonight, Philip. And, instead of retiring like Nehru after 20 or so years, I decided to go back to school full-time. And now I'm a full-time journalism major, TV radio minor, children's studies minor, and my research interests are and will be the Asian American community. Right now, I'm looking at poverty in the Asian American community, how that relates to other issues. And I'm also looking at the issue of bullying. I would like to do some in-depth stories on those topics. And also, I want to start an Asian American news magazine and building my network right now. So I'm looking for people in film and who have CIS digital skills, also writers. And, we would like to start something. Okay, and also I want to just make a comment here to end. So I'm glad I'm the last speaker because I think it's appropriate to give acknowledgement to Joyce Moy. And to Susan back there, who did not introduce herself, which she really, you know, those who really should speak the most, you know, are the ones who stay in the background. But Susan, I definitely want you to, you know, get your turn at the mic. No low-keying tonight on that. But I just want to say that I didn't have a chance to tell Joyce how very proud I am of the publication that she's come out with. This is really beautiful because it's Asian American education that everyone can hold on to, can read, can pass along. And you know what? If we can't do it one way, we do it in so many other ways. This is why I took up journalism. I want to be take up some form of activism and education. We can all do it on our own, in our own ways. And you know, I just want to acknowledge the work that's being done here. It's really important, and certainly none of us can do it by ourselves, but I think together, if we network with each other and if we know of each other's interests, we should help each other. Thank you.
Thanks, Loretta. It looks like we have one or two more people, so.
My name is Cecilia Gulas. I'm Filipino-American in background. I am a CUNY alumni, and I came here to the United States with a PhD because I got a Fulbright Hayes scholarship from the Fulbright grant to study at Fordham. But when I was here in New York City, I said, I'm interested to know about nursing because most of the Filipinos are in the nursing industry. So I said, I better get to know what nursing is about. So one day I walk into the Borough Manhattan Community College and I told the registrar, I want to enroll in a nursing school. So when they saw my transcript and I had all A's in biology, in anatomy, in chemistry, in physics, they said, sure, you can get in. So I studied in CUNY and I took my nursing in 2 years. And I was very lucky because when I interned in various hospitals like Bellevue and all the city hospitals, all my mentors were Filipino nurses. And they were very kind to me. And they said, Cecilia, even you're very good in theory, but you have to learn how to use your hands and all that. But since they were very patient with me and they taught me right from the start how to do it, so I also got an A in both clinical and in theory. But my real love is in journalism, and I've written a book on Corazon Aquino, The Miracle of a President, and it's on the database of the New York Public Library. And my first book, the book was written on the first Mac in the whole world. And now we have the latest Mac, iPad. But I'm not sure if I really want to do it on the iPad. After I have read in the New York Times about what they are doing, making slaves of the Chinese. And in fact, I was there yesterday when they had a big conference. And change.org said that Apple is very greedy and they don't want to acknowledge their short limitations. So I'm also a journalist, and I'd like to tell you that in the CUNY School of Journalism, they have started a chapter on studying Asian American journals and newspapers. For example, the Bangladeshi, they have more than 10 newspapers, and the Indian, they have more than 5 newspapers. So I think that's a very good subject for study, and I've also been writing for Filipino American newspapers. Thank you.
Anyone else? Pardon? Oh, yes, we have one more person. This is the entertainment for tonight, by the way. Didn't tell you that.
Well, I'm coming to a spring party with snow expected tomorrow. My name is Ravi Basin. I'm an applicant for a PhD program in social work. Wow. My research interest is new populations, possibly immigrants who become disabled and lose their ability to make a living, and a couple of others that are related to what I do. I work with the adult disabled for a program in Manhattan called International Center for the Disabled. I remember coming to America many years ago and people saying, funny, you checked Asian, you don't look Asian. So I had to explain that India is in Asia. But now everyone knows, so. Pardon me? I don't look
Thank you.
Oh, you're welcome.
Okay, and there is one more.
Hi, I'm Donan from Queens College. I worked as a tutor in the academic support at Queens College for approximately 10 years now, and I tutor ESL students. And we do have a significant Chinese population there, Indian. So after Baruch, I think Queens College has the highest Asian population.
Okay, thank you. And Susan, would you close this?
Thank you, Joyce. And thank you all for coming. This is a wonderful event. This is something that we have annually, and I welcome everyone to come back. Loretta, you're just too generous and you're too nice. In any event, I'm also a social worker. I'm a New York State licensed social worker. And with me here tonight is Mimi, and she is actually helping us coordinate the Asian American Social Work Task Force, which I am also a co-chair. So she's going to let you know the upcoming events, and it's going to be held right here in this room.
Hello, everyone. My name is Mimi Ogawa-Spigland, and yes, as Susan said, we are hosting the second Making Connections event on the 24th of February, so in 2 weeks, and to come out, make connections, and see. To meet with other social workers in New York City and support each other. It's a great, great opportunity for anyone to share the experience or anything that you want to discuss about in this about this field. So we are welcoming everyone. Yes, so please. Right, so we do have Facebook, by the way. It's Asian American Social Work Task Force, AASWTF, and you can like us, please. And you can ask us any questions, and of course, we are going to put up the flyer about this event on the 24th, so you could RSVP us. So hopefully see you guys in 2 weeks. Thank you.
Well, thank you, everyone. I hope that you continue to network and help us finish up whatever food is left, and enjoy the evening. And we hope to see you guys again next year. And do stay in touch with us throughout the year. If there's any way you think that we can be helpful to you, please contact us. Thank you.